Buy my book! Buy my book!
So, this is a bit of an interesting day for me. I've said before that I'm an aspiring writer, and I have been for some time now. I do have a few other projects in the works that are actual novels, but today I'm not here to talk about one of them. Otherwise, it might have taken me a few years longer before I made this video. So no doubt by now you've probably heard that the first Winnie the Pooh story by A.A. Milne has fallen into the public domain. Meaning that despite what Disney does with their version of the character, now everyone can make their own Winnie the Pooh project as long as they don't use things that Disney made for it. You probably also heard about Blood and Honey, the shot value horror movie that some indie studio put out to cash in on this. I'd be kinda hypocritical if I bashed them for doing something similar to what I'm about to do, but I don't think the movie looks very good, though I don't plan on seeing it either way. But those two things did plant an idea in my head. Now, I may not be famous, but less famous YouTubers than me have put out merchandise before, using things like Streamlabs or Store Envy. However, those things aren't an option for me. Plus, you have to pay a monthly fee for a Streamlabs account, and for someone as poor as me, that's not really an option. Plus, I honestly don't know what I would sell, even if I did have one of those storefronts. Now, yes, I do have my part-time job and Patreon for income, and I've even started working more hours. But I've got a few things coming up that I need to save money for. One of my friend's weddings is coming up in June, and I'll be needing to take a trip to California for that, which isn't cheap. Even if it's not going to another country, and I'm going there in the cheapest way possible. And then, of course, there's my teeth, which have been messed up for some time now, but I've been a bit too afraid of how much it would cost me to go to the dentist and get them looked at. I don't really have dental insurance besides the state-based Medicaid because I'm not making enough money at my job to meet the minimum requirement for something better. So I've basically been trying to do damage control in whatever ways I can, but if you've wondered why you hear whistles or tongue clicks in my voiceover, that's why. But then it hit me. There is one thing that I can at least attempt to do on my own, and that's to write a story. So that's exactly what I did. Folks, let me introduce you to Winnie the Pooh and the Public Domain. As the name suggests, Winnie the Pooh and the Public Domain is a short little 20-page Winnie the Pooh story that, in addition to being an adventure with every 100-acre wood character that I can now legitimately use, is also a bit of a tongue-in-cheek commentary on the fact that they're now in the public domain. It doesn't get too heavy-handed. There's only one joke about Disney, and it's at the very end. And I tried to write it so that there weren't too many hard words or anything that kids couldn't understand. That's right. Unlike Blood and Honey, my story is family-friendly. And I tried to write it to be as true to the characters as I possibly could. What a concept. And if you donate $10, or more if you can afford it, then not only will you be supporting my channel, but you'll also get a copy of the story to own for yourself that will hopefully still entertain you. And possibly your kids, if you have any. Now, I get that some of you might hesitate to give internet personalities your money, and that's understandable. And I'm basically asking you to pay for fanfiction, albeit fanfiction that's about something in the public domain, so I can legally sell it. But you already know what I'm going to use the money on and what you'll be getting, so I figure full transparency with you might help at least. Click the Ko-fi link in the description below, and with every donation of $10 or more, you too can get your own copy of my original Winnie the Pooh story, Winnie the Pooh in the Public Domain, in your inbox in both PDF and RTF formats. Although, I can send you additional formats if you'd like. To everyone who does decide to buy my story, I thank you for supporting me. This may seem like something small, but trust me, to a small YouTuber like me, it's anything but. I'm the hero of tomorrow, and have a nice day. And remember,
buy my book!